Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
The North American Mastiff, it was a breed that we wanted it to appeal to any and all homes. You know, whether it's an elderly old lady or it's your newlyweds. You don't want to put dogs out into the world that people don't necessarily want. People, not every home is ready for a working dog. But generally, most people are when the husband's away and somebody knocks on your door that you don't know, they're gonna give you that scary bark to, hey, what are you doing? My name's Desiree Coleman. Me and my husband, Percy Daly, we created the North American Mastiff. A North American Mastiff is a breed of Mastiff that we created over the course of, I would say, 16 years. That we have 10 different individual lines of dogs and we utilize 7 different breeds. I would say right now there's probably about 16 kennels in America and there are 5 abroad that are breeding the North American Mastiff. This is Monsterpiece Beefcake. He is our 5th generation. He is a chocolate brindle merle piebald male. He is the offspring of Monsterpiece Moo Moo and Monsterpiece Stetson. He is 4 going on 5. The North American Mastiff came about throughout our experience breeding German Shepherds and Dachshunds, where I learned quickly that people did want a big, beautiful dog, but they weren't really ready for the working ability. They wanted the intelligence, they liked the drive, but they didn't want an over-the-top dog. Yes, the North American Mastiff can jump fences if they want. Some are very, very agile and can actually, I've had some climb a fence. They're your all-around dog. They can work, they can pretty much do anything any other dog can do. In order to make a breed, you have to inbreed, then you have to outcross, then in order to gain a consistent look, you have to line breed. So with so many different lines of dogs, you have to keep line breeding in order to get a consistent look, a consistent type, and a consistent temperament. So with so many generations in, your vision of the dog that you're trying to make will just evolve. Each Mastiff that we put into the breed, it also took something else out. So it was more like putting pieces of a puzzle together, you know? So, you know, there was no clear-cut answer to it. So each cross that we made, we had to then keep 2 offspring back, raise those dogs, then breed it to either a dog that came from our dogs, which was line bred, or then if it was too closely related, then you would have to outcross to clean up the lines to make sure that everything is not too closely related. With all the breeding that we have been doing for over the course of 16 years, we finally got them submitted to actual official registries. To where, you know, you have to gain a consistent look, a consistent type, and with that many different breeds of dogs in it, it's really, really difficult to gain type, look, and body structure. So it's like making a recipe. You know, you have so many different ingredients in that recipe. If there's too much of one thing, it's gonna throw everything off. That's why it took so long to actually do this, because it wasn't a fly-by-the-night sort of thing. Everything had to be documented, everything had to be registered, everything had to be have pictures, and you have to show consistency of your type, because without the consistency to your standard, you don't have a breed. That's just a cross. This is Monsterpiece Showtime. He is a tawny brindle harlequin merle. He is the offspring of sire Monsterpiece Rhino and Monsterpiece Icy. He is our seventh generation breeding, and he will be going on to ACA with this generation right here. The North American Mastiff comes in a wide variety of colors, such as blue and tawny, chocolate, black, fawn, and buckskin. And also the color patterns are brindle, merle, piebald. And also some of the dogs, they do have a merle modifier called a harlequin. The North American Mastiff is different than other types of Mastiffs. They always compare it to a Cane Corso. They don't look nothing like a Corso. Their body structure is different, their head type is different, and their temperament is different. So a Cane Corso, it does love its family, but they do have a lot of drive. And it's so hard to get a good Cane Corso that has that even balance and that intelligence to know when to turn it on and off. On the other end of the spectrum, I would say they're different than an English Mastiff, because an English Mastiff is really, really heavy bone, you know, and a lot of people like to overfeed their dog to make it the biggest and the best. And just like people, a large, heavy dog isn't a healthy dog. You want to maintain a good proportional weight, and you want to keep the weight off your dog, you know, up until they're about 18 months, because their hips don't fully form and go into their sagas till they're 18 to 24 months. I've only came into contact with a few English Mastiffs, but they're so drooly, and a lot of people aren't willing to deal with that, and a lot of people aren't willing to have such a massive dog in their house. Yeah, people are going to be impressed, you know, don't get me wrong. I wanted to have a middle range of Mastiff to where it's not too large, but not too small. Some are needy, I'm not gonna say that, because a lot of them like to follow you to the bathroom. I've had that a lot with my dogs. But initially, we want them to be free thinkers and think for themselves. So if they are on your property and there is somebody, you know, that comes on your property that you don't want, or let's say a predator is on your property trying to attack your chickens, they're going to do what they got to do. Monsterpiece Oreo, he is our fifth generation of dogs. He is the offspring of Cookie and Boss. He is a black merle. He is also a tweed merle. Tweed is the shades of different types of black and gray in his merle. He is 3 years old. Generally, I try to be a good judge of character when I sell breeding pairs to people, because when I sell breeding pairs, I sell dogs that complement each other. And there are some responsible breeders that are like, hey, should I breed to this dog? Or what do you think about, you know, this breeding or this puppy, etc. There are truly some that are breeding true to type, but then there are others that are just totally going off of their vision, where they say, you know, creating the new breed standard. And you can't make a new breed standard. The standard's already set. And you can't change the vision of the dog, because people want a North American Mastiff. That's what they come for. So why are you trying to sell them on something else? You know, I do have some people that are concentrating more on the working abilities. So they do have higher drive animals. But ideally, what I was seeking to do was to have a friendly dog, where it has the knowledge to know that, hey, this is my family and I love you, not a wild, crazy dog. The health issues of the breed are cherry eyes, because we did use Mastiff breeds, entropion, and hip and elbow issues. But with, you know, working with our veterinarians, all the new breeding stock are hip tested to ensure that the quality of the dogs are at a higher level now that we have our breed type and our standard and our look is more consistent. This is Monsterpiece Kong. He is our sixth generation dog. His sire is Samson and his dam is Monsterpiece Cookie. He is a blue male and he is an upcoming stud. He is a year old. We don't share what breeds that are in it as of right now because it's too new of a breed for people to tamper with it, because I feel that some individuals have been DNA in their dogs or just guess and say they have Dane in it, they have Pressa, they have Pitbull. Believe me, I heard everything. But we don't have none of those dogs in it. And for each thing that we put in it, we know what it took to get it to where it is. Not every dog of every breed looks the same. So what your vision of a Rottweiler might not be mine, you know? So we health tested the dogs and we picked the right ones that fit the purpose, had the right temperament, had the right look, had the qualities that we were going for. Now that we laid the groundwork, it's now recognized by International Canine Association, and the seventh and eighth generations will be moving on to American Canine Association, which is the parent company of International Canine Association, known as ICA. There are roughly 100 North American Mastiff that are registered within the United States, and some are abroad. And I know this physically because I personally register every single puppy that I sell. And I register it directly into the owner's name. This is Monsterpiece Smurfette. She is a one-year-old female. Her sire is Samson and her dam is Monsterpiece Cookie. She is our sixth generation breeding. She is a blue female. She is one going on two. We try to uphold the integrity of the breed with strict contracts where I don't allow any crossbreeding of the dog. Also, I do have in it that before you breed your dog, if you don't have two breeding dogs from me, you have to get written notarized consent before you actually do breed your dog. In this world, there's always greedy people out to make a quick buck. That's just how it is to it, you know? And when you're creating something good, there's always gonna be haters or people that wanna put their hand in the pot, try to feed off your hard work, or take your dogs and turn it into something that's their vision. But the honesty is that people want the North American Mastiff. They want the breed type, they want the breed look, they want the breed temperament. If you're interested in the breed, I would say come to meet Desiree Coleman with Monsterpiece Kennel, because we're the breeders and the founders of the breed. So we know all the dogs that it took to make up the breed. I know the downfalls of each and every line. So I pretty much know which piece of the puzzle to put together with which to make a well-rounded dog.
Do this shit for real. When we was down and we had nothing, we had to share a meal. We put the shit in overdrive with no steering wheel. Shorty throw that thing back in a pair of heels. Yeah, and she be riding on that thing like a Ferris wheel. Yeah, I love them dark skin, brown skin, caramel. You know I had to bring it to the hood like she carrying silver when she keep on turning head. Cause when she woke that thing.